Well, ladies and gentlemen, Gary Hart has stepped into the ring here on this cage match, and we're trying to pick up what he has to say.
I know what you are good at, bad as you want to be. I know what you're good at. And as far as you're concerned, everybody knows how good you are. But you see, I have Bruce Overbody, the million-dollar man. And I wanted to challenge the winner of this match, be it you, or be it you, at the earliest possible convenience on television in a cage to let everybody know that Bruiser Brody is better than you and me.
Well, there you have the challenge from Gary Hart, ladies and gentlemen, as he has walked into the steel cage and has challenged the winner of this match to meet the $1 million man, Bruiser Brody, at the earliest possible date. Casey shows him what he means as he knocks him down. And I believe Gary Hart is going to get out of there right now. And the cage match start. It's Kat Casey and Chris Adams. Oh, we're here at the Memorial Coliseum in Corpus Christi for a cage match strictly for television. Oh, and it's Adams diving into that cage. And Casey's Adams, the door's been closed now. Casey picks up Chris Adams, slams him to the mat. Casey is going up onto the top rope. Adams is right there. Adams reaches up, grabs Casey, and throws him down. Chris Adams has thrown Scott Casey off that top rope. Don't forget, in 2 weeks, Texas All-Star Wrestling will be at the Mayburn Civic Center in Temple, Texas, with Texas All-Star Wrestling on the road. The camera crews will be there. Well, what exciting six-man tag team matches we had. Remember, those six-man tag team finals will be the Freeman Coliseum in San Antonio on Sunday, January the 12th. We'll be there to pick up the action for you. Chris Adams holding on to Scott Casey. Casey tries to move just a little as Adams locks that sleeper hold on in from behind. The referee is George Stevens here in the cage match. Adams holds on to the side headlock. Oh, Casey gets him up and drops him across that knee. The Cowboy, Scott Casey, has dropped Kiss Chris Adams across the knee, and Casey went diving after him. Adams wasn't there. Chris Adams. From Stratford on the Avon. You saw him earlier here today with Fantasy. Up front with Fantasy. It's going to be an interesting segment. We hope you fans are enjoying the Texas Cup that has been in your city. It's already underway, and remember, the Texas Cup in Texas. If it's your city, don't miss it. They lock up. See who comes out of this with the leverage. The biggest stars in professional wrestling are with Texas All-Star Wrestling, and they are touring in January throughout the state of Texas. Don't miss it. And now it is Casey locking the head of Chris Adams up that leg scissor. As the head scissored in between the legs. Adams with a headstand. Adams finds his head being knocked down into the mat. Chris Adams, Scott Casey. Next week here on Texas All-Star Wrestling, our big main event, Bruiser Brody and the Ugandan Giant Kamala. That's next week. Plus, the American Force defend their Asian tag team titles against Killer Brooks and Austin Idol. That's next week here on Texas All-Star Wrestling. Nice to see all the personnel from KRS TV Channel 6 here in Corpus Christi tonight as they carry our wrestling program every week. They're here for the television matches this evening. Adams dives into the back of Scott Casey. Adams pounds ahead of Scott Casey. Stay tuned, ladies and gentlemen, as we'll be rejoining this cage match right after this. Be able to walk after that. Adams has him covered up. Here's the count. It's 1-2. And the referee, George Stevens, getting a little bit of flack there from Chris Adams. Adams thought he had Casey pinned. Adams takes Casey, whips him across the ring. Kicks the legs out from underneath the cowboy. Dives in there with that hit right to the chest. Here's the count. It's 1-2. And Casey kicks him off again. And Adams wants a faster count. Chris Adams reaches down, takes the head of Scott Casey, slams it into the steel ring. Chris Adams takes Scott Casey, brings him over this way, slams his head into the steel cage again. The fans begin to yell, Casey, Casey, Casey. There's a knee across the chest. Casey has a leg over the bottom ropes. Adams complaining he didn't get the three count. Chris Adams takes Cowboy Scott Casey. Oh, he tried to suplex him. Casey turns it around, and it's Scott Casey suplexing Chris Adams. Casey has the fist ready, but he takes Adams instead, slams him into the steel cage. Ooh. I don't know why you'd want to use the fist anyhow. That cage is a lot harder. Here comes Casey. Brings Adams this way, right into the steel cage again. Scott Casey turning things around on Chris Adams. Here's a count from the referee, George Stevens, and it was 2. I'm sure Chris didn't want a fast count that time. Slammed by Casey. Oh, and Adams gets the knees up, and Casey right into the knees. There's a fist to the back of the head. Another fist to the back of the head by Chris Adams on the Cowboy Scott Casey. Adams has Casey up, slams him down. Chris Adams bouncing off the ropes. Shoulder knocks Casey back to the mat. Adams. Oh, it's Casey going in behind. Casey as he rolled up. 1-2. No, they reverse it the other way. It's Chris Adams holding on to the trunks and has got Casey down for the three count. 1-2-3. 1-2-3. And Chris Adams wins it here inside the steel cage. Mark Nulty is complaining. The ring announcer is complaining that Chris Adams had hold of the trunks of Scott Casey. Casey now is complaining. The fans are yelling. The referee, George Stevens, is checking. Casey. Oh, and there's a reversal. Scott Casey has his hand raised. Adams doesn't like it at all. Adams doesn't like it at all, and he is going after Scott Casey, has him tied up in the rope. Chris Adams pounding that fist into the side of the jaw of Scott Casey. Here comes Adams again. Casey moves. Adams dives into the steel cage. There's a kick. Chris Adams comes out of the cage. And Chris Adams has come out of the cage. Casey has been declared the winner. Wait a minute. Here comes a million-dollar man and Gary Hart. Bruiser Brody, the million-dollar man, has come into the ring. And Gary Hart has closed the cage, and it's Brody with Casey. Unscheduled Brody appears, takes the boot to Casey, and now there's that 2x4 that has appeared every time that Brody appears on the scene. And Bruiser Brody is here pounding on Scott Casey. He is taking that 2x4 right to the chest of Casey. Now he's trying to get to the referee, George Stevens. George, better look out, or he's going to fill that 2x4. There's that 2x4 going into the midsection of Scott Casey. Gary Hart is there. You see him egging Brody on. Referee George Stevens trying to keep him back, but who is going to hold Bruiser Brody back? There, the bell is sounding. Scott Casey was the winner of the cage match, but he is not going to get out of here on his own, as Gary Hart is motioning for the Metatrans Ambulance Service to come down to ringside with a gurney and take Scott Casey. We see the red lights, and there comes the Metatrans. Well, when you hear the ambulance, you know that Bruiser Brody is on the scene. Brody has pounded Scott Casey so much with that 2x4 that there's no way that Casey's going to get out of the ring on his own. The Metatrans people are bringing the gurney. And you just saw Brody waylay George Stevens, the referee. Brody is coming out of the ring. The Metatrans people are coming in. Brody is going out through the crowd. And everybody steps aside as Brody moves through the crowd. The Metatrans Ambulance Service in the ring, and they'll be attending to Scott Casey. Well, ladies and gentlemen, our time has expired here on Texas All-Star Wrestling. Don't forget, our big main event next week will have the Ugandan giant Kamala against the $1 million man, Bruiser Brody. Plus, you'll see the Asian Cup on the line as the American Force will defend that against Killer Brooks and Austin Idol. Till then, from the Memorial Coliseum here in Corpus Christi, Pepito Rodriguez and Steve Sack saying so long for Texas All-Star Wrestling on the road in 86.